If you believe only salespeople can sell products and services, then you are wrong. It depends on how effectively was the training process and learning opportunities found during sales to become the best salesperson. Only those salespeople are on the top who sharpen their skills during the learning process and understand their acts that impact the business. Here are 10 tips for the first-time salespeople who are ready to make the mark. 1. Define your goals. Usually, those start from the beginning, that is, direct selling, do not make the most. You need to start from backward and define your goals first. How many customers would be needed to meet organizational goals? To get those customers, you need to identify how many leads are required that would convert into customers. Attention to details, polishing the sales craft, and providing a consistent experience to prospects are a few factors that could add up in your personal goals for improvement. 2. Understand the process. Sales is not a magic or a trick. It's a process that a company has to go through. The process includes understanding the need and interests of customers and then relating it to the company objectives. Product positioning, highlighting benefits, understanding customer behavior, and personalizing every customer interaction would be the key points to take care at this stage. 3. Customer pain points. Any business flourishes if it understands and addresses customer pain points. Before starting the conversation, every salesperson must do the homework of understanding customer problems. Once you know their problems, it would become easy to initiate the product positioning process. How your product fits into customer problem solving. Once you have gained their confidence, you need to guide the customers through the conversion process and later help them with the product usage process. By doing so, your company receives a loyal customer, and you establish a long-term relationship with the customer. 4. Right people, right time. It is meaningless if you do not target those who are actively looking for your solutions. Use customer database to identify customer behavior, demography, locations, and interests. If you fail to contact and generate leads out of the most relevant audience, then you are most likely never going to achieve the sales target. 5. Nothing matters if not measured. Suppose you made a few leads and customers, but how do you know that you are heading in the right direction? Always measure your every action and compare it with the goals set. If you are green in every step involved in the goal, then it means you are doing well. 6. Work as a team. Remember this mantra, no one succeeds without a team. In case you need to approach a lead, you need a team who creates content that draws leads in the first place. Suppose your prospect is ready to get converted, you need the customer service team ready for further assistance required by the customer after conversion. Working in silos is neither going to help you or the customers. 7. Call audits. If you want to work on your presentation skills, we recommend you to sit with those who are the best in your organization. Request them to review your calls and ask them to give feedback. Work on the areas of improvement and keep reviewing calls till such calls become a bow, business as usual. You could also review their calls to understand how they handle a difficult situation with any prospect. Ask your teammates to follow the same and help others to solve day-to-day issues at work the way you do. 8. Look for your mentor. Everyone wants to grow and succeed. It can happen if someone guides you all the way. Self-motivation, focus, and team definitely help a person to achieve success, but a mentor could provide a vision for your professional growth. A mentor would help you look beyond and think out of the box while maintaining productivity and customer satisfaction in focus. Identify the person who you aspire to be, who has already achieved milestones, and has experience in your field of work. 9. Keep a check on your performance. Earlier, we explained that you need to measure your performance by yourself to track the progress. But you need two other factors to evaluate your performance: feedback from your manager and your prospects. Your manager would help you understand your strengths and weakness and would also help you identify the growth path. Your prospects, on the other hand, would share valuable inputs to relate your skills with the sales field. 10. Learn and be curious. Keep asking, what new skills did you acquire? Unless you are curious to know new problems surfacing in the sales field and new ways to approach your prospects, you won't be ahead of other salespeople in your team. Curiosity keeps you competitive. The steps mentioned are just a few of the sales process. Your growth is never restricted to these 10 points. However, you need to develop an experimental culture within yourself, keeping curiosity and learning on priority. Do not forget to measure your achievements with the set goals. Seek for a 360-degree feedback mechanism that helps you improve your skills. Look for mentors who could guide you and provide you valuable feedback. Always keep customer satisfaction in the bull's eye of your career growth board. One way to receive real-time feedback is by joining the GoFounders community. Members of this community proactively provide feedback and share their input that helps you improve in your business and skills required to drive through the customer conversion process.